after we've done all of that, what we're going to want to do is then go through and preview your posts. A lot of times people do not preview their posts, and it's very vital that you preview your posts, because your image could be incorrect. You could have maybe put something that didn't look correct on the site, and you don't want to just publish anything without looking it over. After the post has been published, then you're going to want to scroll down and check it out. Now you're looking at it, what it would look like live. You get to see where it was. Now, this is cool, but because we're not just the average blog, we're going to want to make sure our product is better. So what we're going to suggest you to do is go and copy your title, or whatever the title might be, or you might just want to go there, and then you're going to go to YouTube, and we're going to find the most current video, because people like to see videos and photos at the same time. See whatever you can find, which is the most current video, and basically so I can give some fluff to the story and make it even better. After we do that, then you're going to want to go and embed that video into the site. The way you do that is by clicking the sharing link, and it's going to say embed. At the bottom of the embed portion, it gives you all of these different categories of just different sizes that tend to fit on different websites, in which the size that we would want to use would be the 560 by 315. So we're going to go and copy and paste this. Then you're going to go back to the HTML side. Remember, you can never edit or do anything from the visual side. You can only edit your script and do stuff from the HTML side. And you're going to go in here and paste it at the bottom. Now, the thing about videos is you cannot see a video when you hit preview. So if we were to go here and hit preview, the video would not show up. It would show up as a blank portion. The video is still there. It's just not going to show up in that part. Now, what we might want to do is, to make it a little better, maybe if we go in and we find like another photo of Dr. Conrad Murray to kind of add some fluff to the story. Basically, you're gonna go to Google Images and find another image that's kind of interesting, because you want to add a little flavor. You never want to just put up a blank post like this, because it's not intriguing to the reader. Who wants to continue to read when there's nothing or no reason to read? So basically, we're gonna go here, we're gonna find another photo that's interesting and eye-catchy to kind of start some drama, because you always want to give people a reason to want to keep reading. We're going to go and grab this image. Okay, we got this one right here. Save it to the desktop. And then we're gonna go in and insert it. Now this time, instead of inserting it like the big picture right here, we wanna insert it as a smaller photo to kinda add a little extra height with it. Now what we're gonna wanna do is we're gonna go in, we're gonna insert the photo, but this time instead of inserting a big photo, we wanna insert a smaller photo. In doing that, we're gonna go select our image, pick our image. We're really supposed to rename. We're never supposed to upload a photo that has the same name that you just stole that photo with. We're just gonna go ahead and download the image. So now that the image is uploaded, we're gonna scroll down here. Every time you upload the image, it also gives you that bottom portion right here. Instead of letting it stay as full size, this time we're gonna move it to medium size, and then we want it to kinda go to the left. You know how sometimes you go on blogs and you see the words to the left, and you see the story to the right. Well, this is what we're gonna do, and this is that case. So we're gonna insert it into the post. And now the words should go to the right, and the photo should be on the left. Now what I do to kind of help it out a little is I'll hit enter to kind of move it down some. That way it won't be so all stuck together and so not good. Now that we have everything set up, we're going to try to preview it one more time. Now that the page is done, we're going to go in and preview our change. And that's where the video will be. This is how our story is going to look. And it kind of added a whole lot more flair to it. Then it kind of make it look more pretty. Don't y'all like that? This is our story. This is our post tags. And what we also want to make sure we do with every post that we do, we want to make sure you retweet it. And then you also want to make sure you link it on the Facebook. That's very vital. That was the pretty much quick rundown. We're going to go in more depth in how to make the post pop even more, but that's just the quick rundown so that you can have an understanding of what we got going and how we doing what we're doing. Freddio.com. Freddio.com. Freddio.com.